Hi, this is Zhou Huiming with Xinhua News Agency. Now we're in the tropical rainforest on Bawangling Mountain in South China's island province of Hainan, which is the habitat to the extremely rare Hainan gibbons. Hainan gibbon is the most endangered of all the gibbons and the world's rarest primate. Dubbed as giant panda of Hainan, the Hainan gibbon is currently only found in Bawangling Nature Reserve, which is part of the Hainan Tropical Rainforest National Park. Recently, two baby apes were spotted in the Bawangling Nature Reserve and increased the number of gibbons from 33 to 35. During the ongoing 7th World Conservation Congress in Marseille, France, the IUCN announced that the protection of Hainan gibbons in China is a success for the biodiversity preservation worldwide. So today we're here with the Hainan gibbon monitoring team to pay a visit to the habitat to the gibbons. And if we are lucky today, we can spot the lovely creatures. And on our way to search for the gibbons, let me introduce you something about them. The gibbons live in a rainforest tree over 10 meters tall and rarely set their foot on the ground, making captive breeding very difficult. Gibbons are slow breeding species that take decades to recover their population. And a single incident of hunting or destruction of a key patch of forest could be disastrous. There is a long history of the protection of the rarest species. In 1988, the Hainan gibbon was listed as the first class nationally protected species under the Chinese Wildlife Protection Law, which made it a crime to hunt it. To protect the remaining tropical forest, a ban on commercial logging was established throughout Hainan in 1994. In 2000, the government launched a program that allowed the woodcutters to transform into forest ranger, meanwhile improving their livelihoods. According to official figures, Hainan's tropical rainforest has increased by about 200,000 hectares in the past 20 years, thanks to the enhanced protection and anti-poverty campaigns that wean villagers of illegal lumbering and hunting. In 2019, the Hainan Tropical Rainforest National Park was established. It covers 1/7 of the whole land area of Hainan, including the current and potential habitat of the gibbons. And this move is of great significance for the protection of the species and their environment. And the monitoring team members are the most familiar with the gibbons because they've been working and living here for years. Now let's hear their stories and learn more about the gibbons. This is Mr. Wang, a member of the Hainan Gibbon Monitoring Team.
王东,您在这里工作多长时间了?
35年了。
一直是做这个工作吗?
没有,刚刚参加工作是搞木材,木头采伐, 当时是国家计划经济,我们这个连业局每年要为国家提供10,000个立方木材。
那后来国家就是停采,93年
停采后我们就转为森林管护吧,做个护林员。 也做了好几年,10多年,现在又作为长臂猿监测队员了。
Mr. Wang has been working here for 35 years. At the very beginning, he was a woodcutter. And when the logging was forbidden by the country, he became a forest ranger. And when the monitoring team was established in the nature reserve, he joined the team.
我们现在的这个监测队一共有多少人啊?
现在监测队有24个。
Now, there are 24 members in the monitoring team. 那作为监测队员，咱们日常工作都是什么呢？
就是对长臂猿的监测，对它这个家庭成员的个体数量啊，有什么变化啊，是什么啊，还有它喜欢吃什么食物啊，还有这个它的那些家庭成员的那个婴儿什么时候脱离母体啊，这类的我们都要记录啊。
As a member of the team, his job is to monitor the gibbons and record their information, such as the quantity of the gibbons and their behavior and what they eat. 那你们有时候也需要拍一些照片啊或者视频吗？
拍，这首先跟着监测它，看它吃什么食物，还有什么行为，一般都会都拍照片，还有影像，还有我们还装了很多那种红外线相机，都会跟他录有他这影像，
就采集他们的影像。They also take photos and videos for the gibbons, and they arranged some infrared cameras to catch their pictures.那长臂猿一般都吃些什么呀？
一般是以这植物果实为主了，偶尔吃果实少的季节就吃嫩芽嫩叶。还有我们监测那么久，看它吃最有营养的东西，就掏鸟蛋吃。
很有趣。The gibbons mainly feed on the juicy fruit and buds and bird eggs.And Miss Wang said they found that their most nutritious food are the bird eggs.
那长臂猿一般有一些什么样的这个生活习性啊？比如说，什么时候开始出来活动？
一般是天亮破晓啊，破晓它就会鸣叫。在那个地方过夜的地方，它一起床叫鸣叫。这鸣叫应该就是呼唤它的。家庭成员和对领地的宣誓吧。
Generally, after the dawn, the gibbons begin to sing and awaken the rainforest. And their sing has the purpose, that is to announce their zone and warns other gibbons don't approach.
那就是除了这一点，那他们一般活动的话会下地吗？还是说就在树上？
据我们的监测了那么老这20多年了，目前都没发现它下地，它应该都是喜欢在树上活动了。
是因为他们的这个胳膊比较长吗？
他们胳膊，这些应该也就是他们胳膊长，就是在树上活动。根据那个拉马克的用进废退，应该这个手长就是，
比较方便，
比较方便了哈。已经进化到。要手臂那么长，就是在树冠上生活的。
According to their observation, the gibbons rarely set their foot on the ground. Maybe because they have longer arms, it's easy for them to fetch fruit and swing swiftly among the branches that allows them to live exclusively in the trees.
那我们对于保护长臂猿有没有一些什么特别的措施啊？
特别措施就是那年有了一场比较大的自然灾害，那个威马逊台风过后，很多长臂猿活动经过了那线路都出现山体滑坡，造成树与树的距离太远了，他们都无法跳跃。我们就采取绑绳索，搞索道给它通过。
很有趣。
They also taken some special measures to protect the gibbons. As we know that Hainan is island, that every year there will be typhoons. Sometimes the typhoons will cause massive landslides that affect the gibbons' activities. So the nature reserve staff members built several rope bridges to help them to cross the gullies that caused by the landslides.
那我们建了这个绳索之后，长臂猿会爬吗？
初初就放的时候，他还是有点害怕。慢慢时间长了，感觉他也会感觉到没有什么威胁，他就敢从那里过了。
我们有这个相机拍到是吧？
我们在两头绳索两头都装有红外线相机拍到的。
Initially, the gibbons were suspicious of the rope structure. They were not afraid to cross by the rope. But later, the infrared cameras recorded their crossing. And it is said that later the rope bridges were frequently used by the gibbons.
一般长臂猿的寿命是多长？
是早期做的这灵长类的专家推测是30到40年之间吧，它们的寿命。
It is estimated that a Hainan gibbon can live 30 to 40 years.
那他们的这个家庭的组成状况是什么样子？
家庭中就是一个最主要一个家长是一个大公爷嘛，还有两个一夫两妻的这样的家庭结构。
一夫两妻、
这样的结构。一个家庭成员他一般比较满员的时候是七只左右了，到很多儿子长大就被赶出去另谋生路。
好的。About their mating structure, the researchers found that usually the structure is like one male gibbon and two female gibbons form a family, and that is the most stable structure for the gibbons. AndUsually there are 7 members in the family.
那我们这个长臂猿还有哪些未解之谜呀？
未解之谜就是那些被赶出去的家庭成员到别的地方，早期的怎么组成一个家庭，这个我们也一直没有监测到这个过程。就是他们已经成立后开始在那里定居下来，经常鸣叫了，我们就发现那里又出现了一群长臂猿。这个是这一点。
When a baby ape grows up, it will be chased out of the family by the parents. But where does the single ape go is still mystery for the researchers. And only when the single ape form a new family,We will hear their singing.
那还有其他的吗？
就是还有那些，自然死亡，到底它是怎么死亡？死亡的我们也没弄清楚。早期我们这边有一只很老的、年龄很大的一个母猿，现在也好多年不见了。我们推测已经是自然死亡了，尸骨也没有找到，到底是怎么？个死亡法，我
没有找到任何他的尸骨。好的。
When old ape dies naturally, where has its body, dead body gone? It's still a mystery. And Miss Wang said they have never found the dead body in the forest. Actually, there are still some mysteries about the gibbons stayed unresolved, and we expect that one day the researchers.Can find the answers to these questions. Well, it's a pity that we haven't found the gibbons today, but after the conversation, we learned more about the gibbons. Are you interested in these lovely creatures? Maybe next time we'll have better luck to spot these animals. Okay, that's all for today, and thanks for watching. See you next time.